I'm Deepika Prakash from National Law University, Delhi. The topic of this presentation is data analysis under the subject of research methodology. In every research, there are certain common steps that the researcher follows. They are: firstly, the researcher defines a problem. Then he goes on to review the available literature on that problem. Then he formulates hypotheses or research questions, as the case may be. Then he creates a research design. On the basis of this research design, he goes on to further collect data with the help of various tools of data collection. Once the data is collected, this data is processed, analyzed, and interpreted. And then the final step in the research is writing of the research report. Data analysis is an important step in the entire process of research. Data alone, in both whether qualitative or quantitative research, is insufficient until it is carefully processed and scientifically analyzed and interpreted. The present presentation deals with only how quantitative research data must be analyzed. Now, coming to the meaning of data analysis, Wilkinson and Bhandarkar defines data analysis as a number of closely related operations that are performed with the purpose of summarizing the collected data and organizing these in such a manner that they will yield answers to the research questions or suggest hypotheses or questions if no such questions or hypothesis has been there at the initiation of the study. Another meaning is given by C.R. Kothari, who explains analysis as computation of certain measures along with searching for patterns of relationship that exist among data groups. He further goes on to quote G.B. Giles, saying that in the process of analysis, relationships or differences supporting or conflicting with original or new hypotheses should be subject to statistical tests of significance to determine with what validity data can be said to indicate any conclusion. Now, general understanding is that data analysis, data processing, and data interpretation are one and the same. However, this is not true. All these three steps are very distinctive steps in the entire research process. Quoting Professor John Going, processing of data refers to concentrating, recasting, and dealing with the data so that they are as responsive to analysis, while analysis of data refers to seeing the data in the light of hypotheses, of research questions, and the prevailing theories, and drawing conclusions that are as amenable to theory formation as possible. Now let us go ahead to understand the difference between them. First that we are going to understand is the data processing. There are various steps under data processing, the first step being editing. Under editing, raw data that is collected is checked for errors, omissions, legibility, etc., for further processing. The second step under data processing is coding. Under it, assign numerals or other symbols to the answers is done so that responses can be put into a limited number of categories or classes. Now, this coding can be pre or post. By pre-coding, codes being assigned while the questions or interview schedule is being prepared. That is, before they are prepared, the codes are assigned. Whereas under post-coding, codes are assigned to the answers after they have been collected. Third step in data processing is classification. Most research studies result in a large volume of raw data, which must be reduced into homogeneous groups if we are to make a meaningful relationship between them. This fact necessitates classification of data, which happens to be the process of arranging data in groups or classes on the basis of common characteristics. Data having a common characteristic are placed in one class, and in this way the entire data gets divided into number of groups or classes. Now, this classification further may be according to attributes or according to class intervals. Now, under attributes, they may be based on descriptive characteristics like sex or literacy, or they may be based on numerical characteristics like weight or income. Under class interval, classification is based on numerical distinction, like the difference in height between 5 and 6 feet, the difference of height between 6 to 7 feet, etc. Fourth step under data processing is tabulation. The process of summarizing raw data and displaying the same in compact form, mainly in the form of statistical tables for further analysis, is known as tabulation. It makes research manageable, readable, and understandable. Now, tabulation is essential because of the following reasons. First, it conserves space and reduces explanatory and descriptive statements to a minimum. Second, it facilitates the process of comparison. Third, it facilitates the summation of items and the detection of errors as well as omissions. Fourth, it provides the basis for various statistical computations. Now, there are two types of tables. First is a simple, or also known as frequency distribution, and second table is a complex or cross table. Now, coming to a simple table, under it, the different attributes are stated in the left-hand column, and the frequency or the extent of occurrence of each of these classes are written in the other column. In this, three things are essential. First, the class made must be mutually exclusive. Second, the tabulation must have internal logic and order. And three, the class interval must be carefully and reasonably selected. The following is an example of a univariant simple table, meaning that it has one variable. In this table, the variant is